Today on Let Them Talk TV, you'll learn all the expressions and vocabulary you'll need to understand crime dramas, detective series, whodunnits, prison dramas, legal dramas. So grab your tweed jacket, your pipe, and your deerstalker. A deerstalker, that's the hat that Sherlock Holmes wears. Don't forget your black book and your magnifying glass. So let's go. So you're on the case, you're a detective, also known as a sleuth. But what kind of detective? You could be in the police force. Now, here's a question for you. How many names do you know for the police? Okay, they could be called coppers.
A cop. A cop. How do you like that, boys? And I was going to split 50-50 with a copper.
The feds, cops. Cops is more an American word. In Britain, we might call them the Rozzers, the old Bill, the Fuzz. There are worse terms, but that's probably enough for now. You could go it alone, privately, like Sherlock Holmes. And we've got names for this type of detective too. They are called private detectives, also known as private eyes or PIs, or a Seamus, or a private dick. Yes, that's right, a private dick.
You begin to interest me, vaguely.
Yeah, I'm a private dick on a case. Perhaps I'm asking too much, although it doesn't seem too much to me, somehow.
So what type of detective are you? Now, if you're working on the crime-ridden streets of American cities, you might carry a gun, also known as a piece or a rod. And what about the bad guys? They're also called crooks or villains. What type of crimes will you be investigating? Here's a list of crimes. It's not a complete list. There are a lot of crimes out there. Unfortunately, we won't have time to look at them all, but here are some of the more common ones that you'll hear about in these police crime dramas. And disclaimer here, I'm not a lawyer. I'm an English teacher, and if my legal definition isn't quite right, then please forgive me. So the first crime is the crime of theft. Now the verb is usually to steal. You steal something, that's the verb, but the noun is usually a theft. So for example, you're under arrest for the theft of this bicycle. Okay, you're under arrest, you're taken by the police for the theft of this bicycle. Abduction, and this is to take someone away illegally by force. It could be kidnap, which we'll look at in a second, but there is not necessarily money involved with an abduction. Now, abduction is a noun, and the verb is to abduct. For example, she was abducted from her apartment by three masked men late last night. Now, kidnap is the same as abduct, except you're asking for money, and the money is called a ransom. So for example, they kidnap the heiress and asks for $1 million in ransom. Blackmail, that's to ask for money in order not to reveal some information about someone. Listen, if you give me £1 million, I won't publish the letters between you and the mayor's wife. Embezzlement. Now this is an accounting crime when you illegally move funds from one account to another. Fraud. Now this is deceiving someone for financial gain. So for example, she told investors that her blood testing machine would be a revolution in disease detection, but it didn't work. It was all a fraud. And the person who commits a fraud is a fraudster. A scam is really another word for a fraud. It's a dishonest or illegal scheme to get your money. So for example, this guy on the internet told me to invest in his cryptocurrency. I thought I'd make millions, but I lost all my money. It was a scam. So scam is a noun. It's also a verb, to scam somebody. And the person who commits a scam is a scammer. Robbery. Now that's stealing with the violence or the threat of violence. So for example, the Purple Gang robbed the Anglo City Bank and stole $2 million. So the verb is to rob, and the person who robs is a robber. A heist. This is another word for a robbery, but usually it's a big and daring or dramatic one. So for example, £50 million. It was the biggest jewelry heist in history. A mugging. And this is to be attacked and robbed on the street or in an open space. For example, I was walking home late last night when three guys approached me with a knife and mugged me. The person who mugs is a mugger. Smuggling. That's moving things illegally from one country to another. It could be an illegal thing, such as drugs or weapons, or it could just be a way of avoiding taxes. So you could smuggle cigarettes across the border. Just an example here, he was stopped at the airport for smuggling drugs. The person who smuggles is a smuggler, and the verb is to smuggle. I'm sure you know murder, murderer, but do you know manslaughter? This is killing someone, but without the intention to do so. So for example, you drove your car when you were drunk. You killed a man. That's manslaughter. I think in America, this is usually called second degree murder. I think maybe in some states they say manslaughter, but I think it's not that common in the US. So second degree murder. Once again, I'm not a lawyer. Now there are two types of crime. There are serious crimes, which in Britain we call them serious crimes. But in the US, they are called felonies. And what's the opposite of a serious crime? Well, that would be a petty crime. That's what we call it in the UK. But in the US, they might call it a misdemeanor. So if you robbed a bank, that's a serious crime or a felony. If you stole a sausage from your classmate's lunchbox, then that's a petty crime or a misdemeanor. Now we've got some words and expressions that you, as a detective, might use with your fellow detectives when discussing a crime or with the police or even when you're talking to criminals. A clue, that is a piece of evidence that helps solve a crime. We found a clue. It's this black book. It has the murderer's fingerprints all on it. But now it has your fingerprints on it too. Oh dear. Oh yes, sorry about that. To be at large. This means a criminal who's not in prison because he's escaped, or a suspect who hasn't been arrested yet. So for example, he escaped from prison 12 hours ago and he's still at large. A manhunt is underway. Oh yes, a manhunt, I should explain that. A manhunt is the search for a suspected criminal or an escaped prisoner, a prisoner at large. Foul play. This is an expression and it means that we suspect that something illegal has taken place. So for example, this suicide note was written by a right-handed person, but Lombardo was left-handed. I suspect foul play, Sergeant. Perhaps it was murder. What, you think it was murder? Person or persons of interest. This is somebody suspected of a crime by the police. We are seeking two persons of interest for the Paddington Green robbery. By the way, this is one of the very few cases where the plural of person is persons, not people. This is an exception in crime detection. A mugshot. This is a photograph taken of a suspected criminal at the police station. Just like this. If a crime has been committed, there may be a police cordon. This is the yellow tape, I think it's normally yellow, that usually separates the public from the scene of a crime. An ex-con. This is somebody who's been in prison. A convict. This is somebody in prison. And here are some words and expressions related to crime that you might hear the criminals using, or perhaps the police in certain situations. The loot. That is stolen goods or money. Quick, hide the loot. The old bill are coming. To stash, or the stash. This is something hidden away. It's usually used for crime, but sometimes it's just things that you keep hidden. So, for example, I should be on a diet, but I have a stash of chocolate under my bed. Do you want some? Okay, obviously that's not a crime to keep chocolate, but as I said, sometimes used for crime, sometimes just for things you keep hidden. Okay, cash is a very similar word to stash. It has the same meaning, except it usually refers to arms or weapons that are hidden away. So, for example, in the basement of that house, they found a weapons cache full of guns and ammunition, enough for a small army. To case the joint. This means to look at a place that you intend to rob later.
Now, Dutch here knows the whole layout. We've been casing the joint for a whole week. How about the cops? You ain't afraid of cops?
To be caught red-handed, which means to be caught in the act of committing a crime. He was caught red-handed stealing the, cookies. Stick 'em up. This is a term the police will use, or a criminal, when they have a gun and they're pointing the gun at you and they want you to raise your hands. Stick 'em up. On the fiddle. This means that you suspect someone is behaving illegally. We've got the same low-paid job, and yet he has a fast car, designer clothes, and takes international holidays, always flying first class. I think he's on the fiddle. Sometimes criminals work in gangs, in which case they are called gangsters.
Hi, Mom, what do you think? Shoes, aren't they great?
My God, you look like a gangster.
But in films, they don't usually use the word mafia. Usually they use other words. So, for example, they might say the mob. And a person in the mob is a mobster. You might hear an individual mafia called a wise guy.
What are you doing? Wise guy don't carry his money in a wallet. Hey, wise guy carries money in a roll, like this. Hey, Bina on the outside. Like that. Come on.
So you've caught the criminal, but that's not the end. You've got to go to court for a court case or a trial. What about all the words and expressions they use there? We can't look at them all, but here's a sample of some very, very common ones. First of all, who are the people that you will see at court? Well, there's the judge.
Order. Order.
There's the person being tried. He or she is called the accused or the defendant. The lawyers. In British English, they're called barristers at court, the ones that, you know, wear a wig. And in American English, they'll be called attorneys.
In favor of...
Order! I call Samantha Cole to the stand.
There may be a jury where the people decide if the defendant is guilty or not. Now, at the end of the trial, if the jury can't decide, then this is called a hung jury, and I think they have to do another trial. Evidence: these are the facts and information that indicate that a suspect committed a crime. They will look through the evidence to determine if the defendant is guilty or not guilty. At court, of course, you'll have a witness or witnesses. This is the person who sees a crime taking place. We have three witnesses who will testify that they saw you committing the bank robbery. And the witness makes a promise that he or she is telling the truth. This is called to be under oath. An alibi. This is proof the suspect was not at the scene of the crime. Where were you on the night of the 22nd when Perkins was murdered? Do you have an alibi? Yes, I was with you, Sergeant. Don't you remember? Oh, yeah, it's true. Circumstantial evidence. This is the type of evidence not drawn directly from the facts, but rather implies a conclusion. So, for example, we know you were in the building at the time of the murder. We know you hated Perkins, but we don't have a witness or a murder weapon. So it's just circumstantial evidence. To cross-examine. This is when the other attorney questions the witness. You've had your time with the witness. Now the other lawyer will cross-examine him or her. So the criminal is convicted. He is found guilty of the crime and sent to prison. Now here's a question for you. How many words for prison do you know? Well, you have a jail, a penitentiary, that's in American English. In British English, we don't say that. And there are lots of slang terms for prison too. Here are just a few examples. You have the slammer, I guess because door slam. The clink, which was actually named after a medieval prison in London, but now you can use it for a prison anywhere. And in British English, we also call it the nick. And to talk about someone who is in prison, you can also use these expressions. To be behind bars, though I suppose if you spent too much time in the pub, then you're also behind bars. So it's a question of context. And to do time means to spend time in prison. For example, you know Doris in accounts. Before she worked here, she did time for embezzlement. Oh yeah. Don't confuse it with to make time. Well, you know, we'll find a moment to do something. Let's make time. So now you have all the vocabulary and expressions. You can watch those crime dramas, read those detective books, and understand everything, or better still, become a detective yourself. Now go out there and catch those crooks, but be careful. It's a jungle out there. Stay mellow and see you next time. Bye.